Welcome, let's talk about some of the important developments discussed in Kurukshetra this time. So it basically focuses on the concept of Make in India and how this has brought a significant change. So post-COVID situation, there have been various opportunities for growth in the terms of production-linked incentive schemes, talking about the national monetization pipeline, the industrial park rating systems, and the national single window system. So there have been a huge number of growth in the young students. And they have been exposed to Atal Innovation Missions through the Atal Tinkering Labs or the ATL Labs. There have been nearly 10,000 such labs which have been created, and the idea under these labs is to make students aware about the STEM, science and technology, and bring them in pace with the industrial developments, with the technological developments, and increase their skill set with a more applicative aspect. Again, there has been an AI-based IoT platform which talks about low power plug and play units for different water parameters, and this has been sent to IBM Watson IoT platform. So as I said, for the education it is ATL and National Education Policy. For infrastructure it is Mentor India and Atal Incubation. For businesses, Startup India, Invest India. For society, the National Education Policy and an Integrated Communication. India's manufacturing growth has registered a significant boom, and there has been various surveys conducted at it, under it. So DST's first National Innovation Survey was held in 2011, and it focuses on the Indian Manufacturing Innovation Index, where we have found Karnataka on a overall most innovative state, followed by Telangana and Tamil Nadu. We do have, on the other hand, states like Assam, Bihar, Odisha, which were extremely low on the index. There have been four pillars of Make in India, which focuses on building up new infrastructure, new processes, new sectors, and new mindset. And each of these have been discussed significantly. Now, when we talk about manufacturing sector, here we have a list of manufacturing sectors which has been focused on, and a list of service sectors that has been brought under the idea of Make in India. So attracting foreign direct investment, now this has been simplified by bringing in a single taxation through the GST, reducing the rate of corporate tax, bringing in FDI policy reforms, and a phased manufacturing program. In the last 8 years, there have been a significant parameters which have been arranged, and India has ranked 142 at the EODB ranking. India has been accorded this rank in 2014, but this has jumped significantly to 63 in 2022. So again, domestic production, foreign investments are some of the key aspects. The growth across various sectors, be it agriculture and manufacturing, has been mentioned in the details, which would be available in the handouts as well. The next is One Nation, One District, One Product. Now, under One District, One Product initiative, the idea is the farmers, the technicians, the manufacturers, the artisans would come and bring in their products at the district hub, and this would be a one common platform through which they can sell their products, and there would be district export hubs which would be created. In the textile sector, we have seen National Technical Textile Mission, Silk Samragya Scheme, and National Handloom Development Scheme. PM Mitra Parks have been established. There has been land acquisition under renewable sources of energy, making India self-reliant. So we have the first India's solar floating power plant started in Kerala, and this is one of the pioneer technologies which has a capacity of nearly 500 kilowatts. India has also has the world's largest solar park at Pavagadh in Karnataka, which has a capacity of 2 gigawatts. Various companies like SoftBank, Canadian Solar, and Adani Green are investing in the projects related to it. Pradhan Mantri Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Maha Abhiyan, which is the Kusum scheme, actually provides farmers to sell extra electricity directly to the DISCOMs and generate a second source of income. Similarly, we do have the Akshay Urja portal and the India's Renewable Idea Exchange portal, which is being hosted by the Ministry of New and Renewable Sources of Energy. So under the renewable sources of energy, the idea is bringing in sustainability, better employment opportunities, market assurance. Steps have been taken for permitting foreign direct investments. Most of the projects are targeted for 2025. There have been National Solar Mission flagship programs. Similarly, we do have bio-CNG, which is 20% blending of the petrol with biodiesels, hydrogen-based vehicles or fuels which would be brought, grid integration for renewable sources of energy would be brought, accelerating the progress by identifying the areas, exploring, bringing in subsidy and hydrogen fuel based vehicles to be brought. Now, transforming manufacturing is again important. So India is one of the world's largest markets and technology is one of the key aspects which has been driving it. There have been various industries such as mobile phone, luxury goods, automobiles, which has been working and rapidly developing. Under the Make in India, we are focusing on sectors like automotives, renewable sources, electronics, food production, ONDC, which is the Open Network for Digital Commerce, AI and Robotics. For AI, there has been global partnership. One of the major economies that we are working with is the G20 group and the GPAI, which has been working together for AI. For electronics, we are again focusing on production linked incentive schemes. There have been various notifications under the aegis of production linked incentive schemes under the NPE scheme as well. So there has been delivery of hardwares, for example, laptops, tablets, all-in-one PCs, servers, the incremental production investments and the employment opportunities for the IT hardware has been mentioned here. The next is the Digital India Mission. Now, this focuses on developing a series where IT professionals would be developed or upskilled. There would be numerous startups being brought and consumer cyber awareness programs which would be released. Fiscal incentives would be given to the applicable applicants, eligible applicants. And then since we are talking about Make in India, Vocal for Local is one of the major slogans that we hear, along with ease of doing business and labor reforms. So during the COVID pandemic, we have seen that there has been an impact on agriculture, reduced female participation rate, educated unemployment being rising, and reduction in the number of livelihood avenues. So the idea is to bring in strategies which could develop entrepreneurs through women's self-help groups based enterprise and household based structures. There have been various community resource persons, for example, Kisan Sakhi, Dr. Didi, Matasya Sakhi, who have been working with the common people and bringing in reforms and development. So the five pillars of self-reliant India focuses on economy, infrastructure, democracy, supply, demography, supply chain, and a good governing system. So strengthening the local economies, delivering the promises right on time. For example, the PM Vishwakarma scheme, which talks about 1 lakh rupees of loan, 18 traditional trades to be covered under it. The Indian toys, 60% increase in the value has been registered, but the imports have reduced by 57%. So that's a good figure for us to understand. Similarly, Gram Panchayat development plan is one of the important plans. Other plans includes Mudra, Vandhan Vikas Kendra, One District, One Product, Common Facility Centers. So local for vocal and a mix of quality innovation and pricing becomes important. When it comes to food processing, again, food processing is an important segment where we have been growing significantly. And as we can see, the number of projects approved and completed has significantly improved. And there have been numerous mega parks which have been established. Now, there are primary and secondary food processing. Primary is the products which are processed through the agriculture products like raw wheat and turned into something that could be consumed. But secondary is creating a secondary from, let's say, fermenting of the fishes or the beer or the alcoholic products. And then there is a tertiary which talks about ready to eat items on the desk. Then the next scheme is the PM Kisan Sampada Yojana, which talks about food processing infrastructure. So mega food parks, cold chains, agro processing clusters to be established. Then there is PM formalization of micro food processing enterprise scheme, which is a centrally sponsored scheme released in 2020, and it upgrades nearly 2 lakh micro food processing enterprises by providing them technical, financial and business support. The next is production linked incentive scheme, again for the food processing under the PLI SFPI scheme, and this is a centrally sponsored scheme to encourage Indian brands in foreign markets to increase employment and bring in better remuneration and remittance to India. The next is superstar sector and water management. So six superstar sectors, the name of those are important. This could be one of the direct questions. So automotives, electronics, renewable energy, roads, pharma and food processing among those, and water being the most important. So each of these have been discussed one by one. So automotive, under the automotive mission plan 2026, roads already we do have the private participation amendment brought under the National Highway Act 1956. Under pharmaceuticals, Covax is the first intranasal COVID vaccine which has been released by India. There are nearly 60,000 generic brands which are being manufactured in India across 60 categories for 20% of the global supply. Then cultural heritage, from tradition to innovation. So we talk about changing the lifestyle, globalization and urbanization. So classical folk dances, music, traditional festivals, art and architecture and literature is some of those. So this cultural tourism has a significant economic impact, brings in a global visibility, offers tourism and opens the door for cultural experience in India. This has been revamped through technology by 3D scanning, digitization, virtual museums, e-commerce platforms being established. The next is GSDP, Green Skill Development Project, which is one of the important projects and programs launched in 2017 across 9 different regions in India, and it focuses on issues related to biodiversity, waste management, pollution, environment, and various courses being offered for the same. Life, under the life themes, we talk about reducing the waste, reducing e-waste, reducing plastic waste, saving water and saving energy. The 4 index which have been identified under the UNIDO green skill index is engineering skills, science skills, operation skills and monitoring skills. Again, the Union Cabinet has approved PLI schemes for 10 sectors. The list of these 10 sectors includes the chemistry sales, electronics, automobiles, telecom, food products and so on. So the benefits is India's growth would actually benefit. There would be better jobs that could be generated, more investment which can be brought, and with better foreign direct investment, we can have significant developments in the field of economic growth. Ease of doing business can be brought into account. Also, FDI can be of 2 types, horizontal and vertical. Vertical, when an organization actually takes the raw materials or brings the things closer to the consumers from the outlets. However, under an horizontal FDI, the idea is to have the same goods in the original country as well as the home country, and therefore it would be called as a horizontal FDI. So to make it more profitable for a multinational, the idea is they have a foreign location, they have a second motive where they get labor cheaper or low cost inputs or low cost raw material as one of the things. So this was about the Kurukshetra edition that we have discussed for September. Thanks for joining in, and we do cover Yojana Kurukshetra and Down to Earth on a regular basis. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful evening.